and the Senate will convene in the Court of Impeachment. I ask senators to be seated. If there's no objection, the journal of the proceedings of the trial are approved to date. And I ask the Sergeant at Arms to make the proclamation.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. All persons are commanded to keep silence on pain of imprisonment while the Senate of the United States is sitting for the trial of the article of impeachment exhibited by the House of Representatives against Donald John Trump, former President of the United States.
President Trump may not know a lot about the framers, but they certainly knew a lot about him. Given the framers' intense focus on danger to elections and the peaceful transfer of power, it is inconceivable that they designed impeachment to be a dead letter in the president's final days in office, when opportunities to interfere with the peaceful transfer of power would be most tempting and most dangerous, as we just saw. Thus, as a matter of history and original understanding, there is no merit to the President Trump's claim that he can incite an insurrection and then insist weeks later that the Senate lacks the power to even hear evidence at a trial, to even hold a trial.
With Lead Manager Rask, like every one of you, I was evacuated as this violent mob stormed the Capitol steps. What you experienced that day, what we experienced that day, what our country experienced that day, is the frame of worst nightmare come to life. Presidents can't inflame insurrection in their final weeks and then walk away like nothing happened. And yet that is the rule President Trump asks you to adopt. I urge you, we urge you, to decline his request, to vindicate the Constitution, to let us try this case.
The relevant timeline in the House reveals the rush to judgment. The denial of due process in this case, of course, starts with the House of Representatives. In this unprecedented snap impeachment process, the House of Representatives denied every attribute of fundamental constitutional due process that Americans correctly have come to believe is part of what makes this country so great. How and why did that happen? It is a function of the insatiable lust for impeachment in the House for the past 4 years. Consider this.
I want to say this for Donald Trump, who I may well be voting to impeach.
Donald Trump has already done a number of things which legitimately raised the question of impeachment.
I don't respect this president, and I will fight every day until he is impeached.
That is grounds to start impeachment proceedings. Those are grounds to start impeachment. Those are grounds to start impeachment proceedings. Yes, I think that's grounds to start impeachment proceedings.
I rise today, Mr. Speaker, to call for the impeachment of the president of the United States of America.
I continue to say, impeach him! Impeach 45! Impeach 45!
So we're calling upon the House to begin impeachment hearings immediately.
On the impeachment, Donald Trump, would you vote yes or no?
I would vote yes. I would vote yes.
Because we're gonna go in there, we're gonna impeach the motherfucker.
But the fact is, I introduced articles of impeachment in July of 2017.
We don't impeach this president. He will get reelected.
My oath requires me to be for impeachment, have an impeachment hearing, and he's the scarlet eye on his chest.
The representatives should begin impeachment proceedings against this president.
It is time to bring impeachment charges against him. Bring impeachment charges.
My personal view is that he richly deserves impeachment.
I'm here at an impeachment rally.
When the Senate undertakes an impeachment trial of a private citizen, as it clearly understands to be the case here, supported by the facts that the Chief Justice is not providing and Mr. Trump is not the president, it is acting as a judge and jury rather than a legislative body. And this is exactly the type of situation that the Bill of Attainder constitutional provision was meant to preclude. It is clear that disqualification from holding future office, the punishment the House managers intend to seek here, is a kind of punishment, like a banishment, and others, that is subject to the constitutional prohibition against the passage of bills of attainder, under which general designation bills of pains and penalties are included. The cases include Cummings, Ex parte Garland, and this Brown case. The Supreme Court three times has struck down provisions that precluded support of the South or support of communism from holding certain jobs as being in violation of this prohibition. Thus, the impeachment of a private citizen in order to disqualify them from holding office is an unconstitutional act constituting a bill of attainder. Moreover, this is the exact type of situation in which the fear would be great that some members of the Senate might be susceptible to acting in the haste the House acted in when it rushed through the article of impeachment in less than 48 hours, acting hastily simply to appease the popular clamor of their political base, the very kind of concern expressed by Mr. Hamilton in Federalist 65.